today we're going to talk about sage and how you can use it to support balancing and grounding in mind and body. Stay tuned. Welcome to the channel. Here on Deep Mind Squared, we talk all things bridging mental wellness and spirituality for nurses. My name's Fola, and as a psych nurse turned shamanic practitioner and Reiki master teacher, I'm here to share with you as much information as I can to support you in really transforming your life and promoting healing, which in turn supports our patients. In this video, I wanted to share a bit about a very powerful medicine or plant, and that of sage, which I'm sure many of you have heard of. Before we get into it, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so that you're updated on future videos. And feel free to share this with anyone you think might find it helpful. So what exactly is sage? You've probably seen it, smelt it, heard about it, and there is a lot of potential in many different plants that exist locally and that we can get internationally as well. But this is really about a very powerful plant that's been used by many different Indigenous peoples to support clearing spaces, clearing away any negative or toxic sort of energies, not only from like a physical environment, but also from that internal. So our body, our mind, our emotions. There's something very powerful about sage that we use before any other, like any ceremonies or sessions, to help just really ground people into the present moment. Something about sage that I think is really important and I'll talk a bit about is the need to ensure that we are sourcing it locally or from the appropriate sources. Especially if we're coming in as non-Indigenous peoples, I think this is super important because it's all about sustainability and acknowledging that we can take and take and take, and then there'll be none for anyone else. The important thing to know too is that Indigenous people, from at least the ones I've spoken with, don't really say they own sage. You know, there's a phrase as well as like smudging. I think that is more connected to a form or a technique, and also like the blend of which the sage and other types of plants or herbs are mixed in. For instance, sweetgrass is something that is oftentimes added. Another important one is like cedar. And there is a whole bunch of medicine within that, which I don't really feel like I am the person to talk about that here. But sage has just been so supportive for me, and anytime I'm feeling really overwhelmed. So I want to encourage you to find a local source of sage, the plant. I have some here that I was gifted. Someone had gone to harvest this just locally. So this is from Alberta. I believe it's like prairie sage. Yeah, it smells good. It's really dry this year. That's what I've noticed. Not that I'm like an expert again in sage picking, but there's something really powerful if we can properly go and harvest our medicine. If you can connect with people who are local Indigenous folks and connect with them, see if they have opportunities to go and learn about how you go and harvest, because there are certain protocols in place before you just go start picking things. I know for me, I have my own process in which I do that, and it's also important that we don't over use or overtake from the land. But there's something very powerful when we take this plant and we really connect with the energies of the plant. So what we can do is, you know, just thank the plant for the energies and the purification, the cleansing that it brings, the sense of clarity and grounding. I like to take it, rolling it up too in the hand can be nice, just by taking a small amount and just really sensing that energy, thanking it. And you can place it in, a lot of times people use like a shell, something that is obviously burn resistant. I have this lovely little glass container because I love the like 8-pointed star. And you can light it, preferably with matches. I have yet to be able to find matches in the city. I don't know where matches exist. I thought that would be way more accessible than it is. So I have a lighter I'm going to be using today. And yeah, you can say whatever prayers you need to, just lighting it a bit. It's not like you have to catch the whole thing on. One thing too, from what I've understood, is like you never blow out when you've lit it. If it's burning too much, you can, like, I think just try to move it around to try to get the flame out. But that's one thing I've heard is not to actually blow out the flame. What I like to do is use a feather, or if I don't have a feather, I will use my hands, just holding the hands over the smoke from the sage that's burning, and really just being aware of cleansing that energy, anything that might be there. And then starting from the top of your head all the way down, you can just kind of bathe yourself with that beautiful, beautiful smoke. And anywhere that you feel called to, front and back, heart space, down to your feet, spending as much or as little time as you feel called, but really it's just that intention. It's like you're bathing yourself with this smoke. And you can like give any thoughts or any energies to the plant, to the smoke as it's burning, just asking it to cleanse you. Do my feet. And then something else I like to do is to take this and go around the room, which I won't really do right now because obviously you won't be able to see me, but you can go to the four corners of the room or any corners, go around the door. You know, people will actually come out, and this is some work I do too, to cleanse a space. There are like certain processes to do that, but it can just be really helpful if you feel like there's anything heavy or negative in your home, in your workplace. I think it's ideal if you're in like a healthcare setting, especially here in Canada. Many places have access to Aboriginal cultural helpers or Indigenous like support workers and elders, and they can come and do this work if you ask. There's certain protocols that they might follow, and also there's certain ways in which the healthcare system needs to support that, especially when they're Indigenous clients or staff. And I think it's important that we incorporate this sort of healing within our like workspaces. It does make a huge difference. One team I used to work on, we actually had Aboriginal cultural helpers, and they would come and smudge with our patients, and it was so amazing to be a part of that process, to see how, you know, like people who maybe were struggling with their mental health and the overwhelm were able to get some extra grounding, extra spiritual connection through this, dare I say, simple technique. So this is something you can do. Again, being mindful that where you're sourcing your sage, there's a lot of controversy around using white sage from like the stores you can buy them in, a lot of metaphysical shops. And it does smell really good. I won't lie. I think it's like one of the better smelling ones. Unless, obviously, sweetgrass. There's something about sweetgrass. Can't even remember where I got this. Someone gave this to me, and I just keep it. I've like wrapped it up, keep it there. Maybe I need to make a sweetgrass video. But being mindful that you're not purchasing this, because a lot of times, again, the sustainability on our earth and taking from people who this is like their medicine. I don't think we need to burn huge bundles of sage every day and like waft them around our house. Like, really connect to the spirit. And even if you can't maybe burn sage, you can just take the plant. I have this hanging around because it was still kind of drying, and you can just literally ask the spirit of that plant to cleanse the space. You can use it to cleanse your body, I think, because plant spirits are very, very powerful, and they're here to support us. So let me know in the comments if you have found sage to be a beneficial plant, or any other plant, sweetgrass. And I'd love to hear, let's share like how you use this. And if you have any suggestions for people watching the video, and feel free to share this video to anyone you think might enjoy watching it, and make sure you hit the like button. But I'm gonna pick a card right now from this beautiful plant spirit deck that a friend of mine is made, and we're just gonna see what card comes through for you today. Queen Anne's Lace. Look how beautiful that is. Oh, let me see if I can get it. I haven't really pulled a card for everyone here in a long time. There we go. Queen Anne's Lace. Look how, oh, it's so bright. I'm trying to get it there so you can see it. It's like this beautiful, like, bloomed flower just super expansive. When I see this, I think of like our crown chakra, that chakra at the top of the head, opening, and the expansiveness that comes from us connecting more to spirit, connecting more to the energies of plants, connecting more to ourselves. Whatever spirituality looks like for you, it's important, because when we have connected and open, then we're expansive that way in a grounded sense too, which is why sage is so great, and like rooting ourselves down into the earth, then we can really start to blossom. We can really start to see more abundance in life. So just that reminder that whatever might be going on for you, to know and trust that there's a reason that that expansion is happening right now. And yeah, you can be that beautiful queen, beautiful queen. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will catch you all in the next video. Happy saging.